From this moment on, you will now be known as Sharkbait.
Sharkbait! Ooh-ha-ha!
Welcome, Brother Sharkbait!
Sharkbait! Ooh-ha-ha!
Enough with the Sharkbait.
Sharkbait! Ooh-ba-ba-ba-do.
What's up, everybody? This is D from Brooklyn checking in with an update, and I think you may have noticed it already, is I got some angelfish. Now, this tank is pretty narrow, and I don't plan on keeping them in there forever. But these guys are still babies, and I thought it was a good time to move them to the planted tank. Of course, they go out of the shot. But these are my baby angels. They're adorable. There are actually three of them. The other one is still in hiding, but they're still getting used to the planted tank. They're probably the smallest fish in here right now, so they're being bothered a little bit by the big boys. So the gold mollies don't bother them. Flake mollies don't bother them. Right now, the only fish that actually bother them is my black skirt tetras. They can be pretty of a territorial fish because they've been in here the longest. They're pretty old. They're in here at least 4 to 5 years. Here's my other one up here. I just love the patterns on these guys. Look close if I can get them. There we go, if we can adjust the color there. They're really pretty. The colors and patterns are what attracted me to these guys, because it's not just that black line, but this one has like a faded black pattern. Beautiful fish. They're gonna get to about 5 inches or so, then I'll move them out. But for the time being, I can keep them in here amongst the plants. They seem to be really happy living in here amongst all the plants. They stay in the shaded areas right now. And a beautiful fish. This one, where it's actually a gold, I'm hoping that it turns out to be koi. Sometimes you get a fish that's misrepresented. But I don't think it's a koi, but it mimics the colors of a koi. It looks like a regular gold. But beautiful fish. I thought I'd share them with you. And I always thought of the angelfish as the poor man's discus, as a lot of people will know. The poor man's discus. Beautiful fish. And I've tried a lot of different types of smaller fish. But the problems with many smaller tetras, like even neons, I'm surprised that Neo has been around a long time. Neo, if you guys watch my videos, is my little neon tetra. I started out with a school of them about 5 years ago, and Neo is still in here, swims by itself. I had two of them up until about 4 months ago, and then it was just one. I started out with a school of six of them. But, beautiful fish. I was trying to see if Neo would come out, but I already fed him, so I guess he's out for the day. And other than that, is not a lot of fish are very long lived in the tetra family, which is why I went to a fish like the mollies and the Congo tetras. They are long lived species of tetra. And I don't like getting fish just to get them. So, I says, the one fish in all these years, I've been keeping fish since I was a kid in the 70s and early 80s. And these are one of the fish that have stood the test of time. The angelfish is a beautiful fish. I may even get lucky enough to have them breed in here, but to have them breed, I have to grow them out to a significant size. So I don't know if that's going to be in the plans, but we'll see what happens. If any of you guys have kept angelfish or have got any special tips for angelfish, put them in the comments below, because as you can see, where I keep a lot of saltwater fish, I started this hobby in freshwater a long time ago, and I still get great enjoyment in freshwater fish tanks and just fish in general. I don't have a favorite fish. Oh great, of course the telemarketers are calling now. But I always danced around buying these fish, and I thought, what the heck, they had them in my local store, and I says, what the hell, I'll get them. These guys, on another note, I was worried about them picking on them, and they have been ideal neighbors, the mollies, because they're so big compared to the angels. If you look at the angels, they're pretty much just out of the fry state. They're about a half inch, whereas these mollies are about an inch and a half. But they've been good neighbors. They've been actually showing some really good colors. I've been changing up their foods a little bit. So I'm going to try to get these angelfish onto the bloodworm diet. I have various flake foods, and I have the bloodworms, frozen bloodworms, that I've got them on, and they've been doing okay. Now they're a little less skittish. They've been here for a few days, so they're kind of mingling around and exploring the tank, and really pretty. Question for all of you angelfish breeders out there. Do you have a proven method for sexing them? I know these guys are small, so I doubt if you can really tell the species sex apart. Some people say that it's the shape of the head. These guys are too small to look for the oval tube. Of course, these guys are still babies, but there's a good shot. He finally came into light. I'm hoping that this is a male, this golden, because he does have like kind of a hump. Those may both be males, but I don't know. I'd be lying if I said I knew. I'm just reading my old books. But I'm hoping, I hope that I have at least one female out of the three of them. That would be cool. This guy back here, my old black skirt tetra, he gets a little fidgety once in a while and nags him a bit, so to give him a little spanking if he doesn't behave himself, be a good neighbor. I took a lot of the plants out. You can see there's a lot of open swimming space now, because I was just getting tired of the whole top of the tank being crowded out by plants, and it was actually cutting off a lot of the light to the lower section of the tank. So this has opened up a lot of the tank. I'll go back so you can see. I cleared up the whole left. One good thing about clearing up that space is not only do the plants get more light, but I noticed the fish's colors, if you look real close, become much more vibrant. I mean, having the plants in the tank is definitely very beneficial to fish like angels and mollies and fish that actually come from very densely populated waters where there's a lot of plant growth. There's something about the chemical makeup that gets left by the, you know, the chemicals that are released by the plants and the way the nutrients are taken up by the plants that really benefits the fish. Even the tannins from the wood, you know, get released in the water. You might be noticing, actually, my DIY feeder. I got sick of the suction cup coming off, so I got some styrofoam and packed that in there. The fish love it because as they peck on it, it moves around, so it's never sitting in one place. But that's a story for another day. But also, if you look, I do have areas of dark space in the tank, which if you look, it's the far right. It's nice and dark. It gives the fish a little feeling of cover. It actually provides a nice little hiding spot for my shrimp. And if you add new fish, it's always beneficial to have a dark area in the tank to make them feel secure. As you notice, the angels kind of stay hovered around that area and dart in and out of the cover, but they're feeling pretty good right now, and I'm happy to have them. So that's about it for today. I want to thank you guys for watching and appreciate your comments below. If you're not already a subscriber, click the subscribe button. And give me a thumbs up if it ain't too much trouble. And with that being said, that's it for today, man. Tank on, everybody. This is D signing out. See ya.